you're probably thinking this is Africa, right? It's cheap. But you might be surprised if I told you that it's going to be quite expensive living here, especially if you buy stuff imported. Man, this place has changed in the last 8 years. I mean, that bridge here wasn't there. That building here wasn't there. So in this video, I'm going to give a total calculation of how much I roughly spend here in Dar es Salaam, Tanzania. I'm going to do that in three ways: shopping, going out, and bills. So I'll try and keep it simple to those three things. If you want to add other stuff, that's up to you. And don't miss the end of the video where I'll do a total cost per month calculation of how much roughly I spend here in Dar es Salaam, Tanzania. I know I live differently to some people, I'm British and all that stuff, but should still give you an idea how much it costs to live here. So this is one of those rare occasions where it's raining here. Rainy seasons are like November to January, June, July time. Oops. So for the simplicity of this video, I'm not going to talk much about cars and all the other expenses. If I didn't get given this by my company, then I wouldn't probably get a car because it's just too much hassle. My work fixes it and stuff if there's a problem, and the only thing I pay for is petrol. If you don't have a car, then use Uber, it'll be roughly the same price or cheaper. Place Cocoa Beach, they're completely doing it up at the moment. Changed a lot in the 8 years. The restaurants burnt down, now they're redoing it up. And so when they do it all up with all the restaurants and everything, it's gonna be fantastic. I'm just gonna get the basics for the week to give you an idea. I know you can go to a local market, buy all those cheap things at the local market, but I don't particularly want to spend all my Sunday running around trying to find different food. So for me, supermarket is king. I can get everything here, well, most stuff. So this is where I go. See, these mushrooms are really expensive. I'll get them, but usually I don't get them. Spinach and some. So that's enough fruit and veg for now. Let's move to something else. I usually get fish, but they don't have any fish today, so it's hit and miss with this place. Chicken, sausages. One thing that's weird, they don't really seem to have any local cheese. I always have to buy imported cheese, which is usually expensive. They have mozzarella, which is local, but they don't seem to have much else. So this stuff is local, but this is all imported. Like, halloumi, I'll try that. That looks like local. There's nobody here. Try and get in myself. Chopped tomatoes, pasta. I think that's it. I'll just get bread now. Bread. See how much all this costs. A couple of bags as well. Thank you. Thank you. This one. Thank you. Sante. Okay, so the total cost for all that is 178,000 shillings, which is around 78 US dollars or 57 UK pounds, which is not that bad, but don't forget, that's just me. I'm buying for myself for the week. Okay, so now I'm gonna find an example for going out. So I'm gonna find a restaurant and have something to eat and drink, just to give an example. So let's go. Oh.
I know you can go to all these cheap restaurants, the local ones, the cheap food and drink and all that stuff, but I just want to go somewhere touristy for a change. Be honest with you, the food here is not that great, but it should give you a varied range of prices. Actually, I shouldn't complain. It's not the food, it's the service that's not usually great here. That's the thing.
Oh, look, some of my friends are here. I can't believe it. That's Kim there. Hey, guys. So this is Thai, so I'll give you some idea of prices here. Sushi. Green curry chicken, which is 28,000, which is equivalent to $12, which is equivalent to £9, I think.
So local beer is about 4,000, 5,000, but this is 12,000 because it costs a lot more, but I thought I'd treat myself today.
Ah, Santé. So I'll probably say this meal I'm about to have is kind of expat prices. It's kind of medium to high price. It's not cheap. There's a fly in my soup.
People fly.
Hmm? A fly in my soup. So you probably think it's a bit weird eating Thai food in Africa, but yes, it is very weird. Okay, so that was good actually. Right, let's see how much that was.
Okay, so it's come to around 55,000 shillings for the curry and three beers, which is equivalent to $23 or around £17.
You know, I haven't been back to the UK for a long time, but that's probably average price for the UK, I think. But it's a touristy expat place, don't forget.
So let me go back to the apartment now to see how much the bills cost.
Okay, bills. There's three kind of bills I'm gonna go through. Okay, there's my phone bill. I pay probably 35,000 shillings per month for my phone internet. Then the second one is the internet in my flat. So I pay, I think I just paid it yesterday, so 125,000 shillings per month for the broadband, which is very fast. 4K on your internet TV and everything like that. And then the third thing is my rent and bills. Well, actually, I don't actually pay rent. My work pays for my apartment, but the utility bills I do pay for. Okay, so according to this, it ranges from around 400,000 shillings, and it's sometimes each, this is per month, so sometimes it's 400,000 shillings, sometimes it's 256, so it ranges. I had a lot of people staying over then, so it's not going to be more expensive than that. Plus $100, so that plus that is equivalent to 420,000 shillings is equivalent to $180 or £135 plus another $100, so $280. So it's not going to be any more than that. $280 equivalent to about £200, £208. So that's my bills for the month. Okay, so add all that up for a total cost of living per month here in Dar es Salaam. We started off with shopping, was 178,000 shillings per week. So times that by four for a month is 712,000 shillings. Then going out was 55,000 shillings. Times that by four again, 220,000 shillings for the month shopping. And then bills was 810,000 shillings for the month. Now add all that up for a total cost of living per month comes to 1.74 million shillings, which is equivalent to $752 or 554 British pound. And that is the cost of living in Dar es Salaam. Thanks for watching.